On December 7th, 1941, Bob Stone of Hannibal was a young sailor stationed aboard the USS California, which was in port at Pearl Harbor, Hawaii. A little after 7 a.m., the peace of that quiet morning was broken.
It was about 7 o'clock in the morning. In fact, I had just finished eating and had gone out on the deck outside the where we ate our meals. And I was sitting out there and waiting on the paper boy to come by with the Sunday morning paper. And they were setting up the church for the church services up on the bow of the ship, master at arms, that's same as a policeman on the ship. He was up there visiting with those guys that were setting the chairs up and everything. And all of a sudden he come running back and hollering, "The Japs are coming, the Japs are coming," because he'd been in the Asiatic service for many years, and he was, well, when he saw that rising sun on the bottom of that plane, he knew exactly what was coming, and he was warning everybody to get in six helper. And from then on, all kinds of things happened for the next two and a half hours.
Although it's been 66 years, the memories of that day are still fresh for Stone.
I can still see the wild, chaotic, carrying on that was going.
A great piece. I've known her all my life as well, but.
And I think about the guys that I went in service with and didn't make it.
Stone does not believe Pearl Harbor holds the significance for Americans as it once did.
People who haven't been in the service, I don't know, they have a different outlook on life. You go take care of it, and leave me alone. Let me drive my new Cadillac. They don't realize the rigmarole that you have to go through. It's not all roses and good times. There's a lot of bad times.
Not all Americans have forgotten Pearl Harbor and those who served there. Stone was reminded of that fact by the Oakwood Elementary fourth grade students of Jess Corcoran, whom Stone visited on Friday morning. Corcoran's class paid tribute to Stone in a special way.
God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above. From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans, why we call.
For additional details, please see the accompanying online story with the Saturday, December 8th edition of the Hannibal Courier Post. For the Courier Post, I'm Danny Henley reporting.